African Union, the Amnesty Month of September, is all about how do we silence the issues of guns in our continent and in our country. I'm sure you're all privy to the devastating ravages we are facing, the dire consequences we are facing as a country in terms of the effects of the proliferation of small arms and light weapons. We are talking about issues of illegal exploitation of our natural resources. We are talking about issues of insurgencies in some of our neighboring countries. We are talking about issues of armed conflicts, both inter and intra. Not forgetting, of course, terrorism and issues of cattle rustling. When these issues became a matter of grave concern, our AU heads of state met in Addis Ababa, and they made a solemn pledge. What did they say? They say that we are not going to bequeath the burden of wars to the next generation of Africans by the year 2020. And they also undertook to end all wars in Africa by the year 2020. That was the solemn declaration and the oath undertaken by the AU heads of state. As a result of which, in 2020, in an ordinary session of the AU, our heads of state adopted an AU master road plan in terms of coming up with practical steps towards silencing guns in Africa by the year 2020. Practical steps. And pursuant to those instructions, the African peace, the AU Peace and Security Council, on 4th of September 2017, launched what came to be known as the African Amnesty Month, which is cutting across all the AU member countries, purposely for the surrender and the collection of illicit firearms. And this is in line with our African and international best practices. So ideally, the African Amnesty Month is one of the major steps towards realizing the objectives of silencing guns in Africa by 2020. And all African member countries are actually encouraged to implement their activities through what we are doing now, public awareness campaigns. The Kenyan national focal point on the proliferation of small arms and light weapons is one of the key agencies in terms of the prevention, the combating, and the control of the proliferation of small arms and light weapons. That is basically our mandate as a director, and we are domiciled in the Ministry of Interior and National Government. We, of course, do collaborate bilaterally with the direction, and we as well get our mandate from international organizations like the United Nations Program of Action on the proliferation of illicit weapons.